and welcome. I am Maria, and this is my channel. Thank you for coming in. I am doing another take of this. My video that I just posted on flosstube sounds so I don't know why it's robotic. I'm really hoping it's robotic this time when I finish the video. It wasn't that bad when I was listening back to it. It only had a little distortion on it, so I don't know what happened to it once I got it uploaded into YouTube. So we're gonna do this again. So let's go ahead and get started. If you are a returning viewer, thank you for coming in. Hopefully the first video of the day did not discourage you. If it did, then you'll never see this. All right. If you are returning viewer, thank you for coming in. I hope you enjoy the video. And I really apologize once again for such a bad video. So let us go ahead and start our process here. I need to clear this in front of me. I was getting ready to do some cross stitch, but did not get the video thing situated. So. And I just don't feel right leaving that one up. It's just, so this is flosstube number 59, right? I believe I'm on 59. Yes, I am on 59. So let us go ahead and get started here. I almost got this spool down perfect, because like I said, third time that I've done this today. And I really, really hope this goes through. And if I'm not too low, I'm not too loud. I don't know what I'll do. I'll probably cry and just put a chat, a community chat going, I'll do this another day. All right, so first project is the Heaven and Earth Designs pattern that was created by Linda Pringle. Pringles, I believe. I am stitching this on 32 count, 1/1 full cross, 1/1 tent. Sorry, it's 10 stitch. This is where I'm at. I just decided not to focus there. I am right here. This is where I was working. I'm going to come back down and I'm going to start working the diagonal. Just because I'm noticed I'm not wanting to stitch it. It's all the way back to stitch. So I want to get back over here where it's different. So that's what I'm going to do on that. Oops. Alright, the next one I'm going to show is my dream catcher. This is a pattern by, I don't know who's back by, I just know it's from Get On The Rouge. I am doing this on 25 count, 2/1 tent stitch. This is where I'm at on it. Scroll here. Hopefully, get into the eyes here. Going by luck, I'll already in the brow. But yeah, so that is that one. Then I know this is probably going really fast. And that last one did not go quite so fast. three times in a day. So this is my rainbow dog. I'm stitching this on 28 count. I'm on the positive. 2/1 tent stitch. This is where I'm at. I'm really enjoying this stitch. It is what I stitch on most right now because I am trying to get this finished before Christmas. My last project that I've been stitching on this week, or the last week, is
this. It is a test chart for somebody. Test stitchers, and I volunteered. So far, I'm loving the chart. It's me, it's stitching it really well. But this is what I'm on farm with. Outlining the moon right now, and I'm finishing out the outline, and then I'm going to finish that. All right, so that is all my cross stitch. So now, we'll go ahead and show the project bag. And we'll kind of combine it all together. I'm going to show my project bag along with my knitting. If you are not wanting to see the knitting, you can fast forward to the end because I am doing a giveaway. I have three patterns giving away. Two of the patterns is thanks to the store Always in Stitches. It's a quilting cross stitch shop in Indiana, up in Nobleville, Indiana. I go there once a month. I go over there and join the stitching group. Sit over there and stitch and chat. A few of the ladies also do knitting too, so it's kind of cool to have someone discuss knitting with myself. All right, so let us go ahead and get started here. We'll show this one first. This is a project bag I made last Saturday, I believe. Very beautiful blue interior. The project I have in here is a shoulder wrap that I've been working on. This is long white, like a wrap on my shoulders. Around. Got good ways to go. I know I could have done it the other way, but I don't know, this way just I decided to do it because I want the bridges to be this way and then this way. So, yeah. This is not a pattern or anything like that. This is just, a video I found with a repeat stitch, a 4-stitch repeat. And you just keep repeating the same 4 stitches on and on and on. That is that. Really been enjoying that one. I have a good ways to go before that one. And now there. Now we'll do my next project bag. I made this one. I'll probably make more like this. This is has the zipper up here at top. For my knitting projects, I like this idea a lot better than this. Is my scrappy scarf, is what I'm calling it. I took a bunch of my little balls of yarn that I was given. I put it all on the winder, and I put it all on in one ball. I'm stitching as I go. If you've watched any of my Twitch videos, you'll have already. But this is a half fisherman's rib stitch, I think is what it's called. I like the ribbing on it. And it's gonna be nice and stretchy. Versatile, so like it does not matter which side I have on. I really like that factor on this. Okay. Gotta put them back when I'm done with them. Alright, and then my last project bag is this one. I was carrying one of my other projects in it, but it got a little too big. It doesn't quite fit in the bag anymore. So there's this one. It's got this beautiful interior. And really love the crayons.
Cool.
Alright. We'll go ahead and do this other one, always, and the here. Let's see. I am working on a beanie. And it's very bright. Not quite that bright. A little pretty yellow. This beanie is for my daughter. I've got about 2 more inches to go, then I can start weaving. There is that one. And then I have 2 sock projects on the go. I did complete my pair of socks, but I do not have them because my daughter, who I made them for, has already stolen them. And she's wearing them, so. yeah, I have posted them on my Instagram, so if you really want to see, they are, click the link below and get the socks. But I have a pair of red socks that I'm working on. I'm stitching these around, giving them a try. So far, I'm really liking them. I'm doing these cuffed down. So we'll see how those go. Then I started another pair and doing knees toe up. I haven't quite decided how I'm going to do what I'm doing heel wise on these just yet, whether I'm going to do the afterthought heel or if I'm going to do the gusset, on here. I'm not quite made that decision yet. I did try doing these with deep hands, but when I got up to here, I was like, I didn't like it. It's too much stuff in my way. Not having it. And I know I have a lot longer to go. When I'm decreasing, I think I can handle it a little better because I know that I'm coming into the project, but I do not want to be working most of the project with deep hands. Alright, so the next one I have is my twin blanket. Basically, I think it's going to be twin size. It is a scrap blanket as well. I'm taking all my little extra balls of yarn that I have that there's, I don't think there's enough to make like a scarf or something out of. I'm just going to, and I'm putting them. Knitting up and blanket. I don't know, I've always loved crocheted and knitted blankets. I like knitted blankets a little better than crocheted because I like more crocheted blankets bother me. Okay. And then I've got a washcloth I've been working on. This is a linen stitch, I believe is what it is. I really like the pattern that's coming out on it. Okay, this is just a washcloth. I like crochet and knitted washcloth. They're easy to wipe off things and clean them. Alright, so I have one. Oops. I have one final project left. This is my baby blanket that I'm making for my cousin. I feel like if I really put myself onto it, I could have this. I'm already past the halfway point. I'm now decreasing. And I've done that much today. I was right here when I started. I just started the decrease. I
have stitched that much today. So if I really put myself into it, I do think this could be a finish. I may continue to work on it. I like the idea of having it finished. I can start on this project. Which I think, as I was talking in my last video, I believe I may, if I have enough yarn, I may try to make a baby beanie to go with the blanket. That would be really cool. But we will see. Oh, wait. That back in there. Okay, so that is all of that. Alright, so, sorry. Alright, so let's try the giveaway stuff again. Because I'm going to delete that entire video. So if this is two patterns that I got from Always in Stitches. I'm giving each one away separately. This one is Hands On Design. I think it's called Block Party, or it's by Block Party. I'm not sure. I don't know how to read these very well. Yeah, I think the pattern itself is called Block Party. It is a pincushion for the 4th of July. It has some pens that says the 4th. It has the little felt on the back. So if you're interested in this pattern, please like and subscribe to the video. In your comments, use the word pen, yes, P-I-N-S, pens. Just have that, the comment in the comments. The word in the comments below. If you put in for each pattern, you will only win one. So if your name gets called on one and on two of them, you will get the one that your name was called on first. Okay, so the next one from Always in Stitches is called Butterfly Crouche, I believe. It's a cross stitch pattern from Hello, from Liz Matthews. So there is the pattern. You have the big butterfly pattern, and then you also have this little butterfly pattern. I think I see this one in here for sure. I'm not sure if they're the same pattern or if they're just colored differently or what, but I do see this pattern in there as well as this. So if you're interested in this pattern, the keyword is going to be butterfly. Just have that in your comment in some way. Then the last one is a pattern that was given to me by one of the awesome ladies at the Stitch With Me weekend, the once a month thing. Melody gave me this, gave me a couple of different patterns to use. It is by Country Cottage Needleworks. It is spring, one of their seasonal collections. If you are interested in this pattern, put spring somewhere in your comments. Okay, I think I'm good. I knocked off over about 6 minutes. Okay, so if you're entering the giveaway, please be 18 so I can get your email address or get your mailing address so that I can mail it to you. I think that's all I have right now. Like I said, I will be removing the other video so nobody accidentally posts on that one. And hopefully this one will upload before the end of the night. And yeah, hopefully. There's no issues. Video? Brain? There's no issues with this video? First video I did of the day, I got all the way through it, went to listen to it, had no sound at all. So I started the second video. Like, I got all the testing, I did a test video, just kind of test thing. Seemed to work fine, volume was working fine. Posted it, like, realized after I got the video all the way done that it was messed up. But it wasn't that bad, it was just a little distorted in areas. And it wasn't until my husband called me in the room to let me know how bad it was, that I realized I'm just going to do this whole thing. So, 3 flosstubes in one day. That's what I get for not doing flosstubes. But, oh well, it's life. It's been a crazy day as it is. Anything else? I think that's all I've got. If you're still here listening to me ramble, I appreciate you. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hopefully I didn't go through it too fast. And I will probably do another floss tube in about 2 weeks, maybe 3. I won't be doing them weekly. I'm not doing enough stitching to do it weekly. But I will be doing lives. That is something I am going to try to do, is do more consistent lives a week, maybe 1 to 2. The same with Twitch. I'm going to be on Twitch 1 to 2. So we'll be getting Twitch videos as well as the live videos. But actual philosophy videos, I probably won't do those but once. Every 3 weeks, give or take, depending. All right, so I'm out of here. Hope everybody has a great week, and I will see everybody next time.